At bago po tayo magsimula, ipapakilala ko po sa inyo ang ating training team. Ako po si Forrester Moreno L. Santander Jr. and I will be your host for this training course. At syempre po, hindi naman po ako solo lang na nagtatrabaho dito. Mas malaki po yung ginagawa ng mga kasamahan natin behind the scenes. Kami po dito sa Training and Manpower Development Services Section ay pinamumunuan ni Dr. Jill Siladan. Siya po ang aming Section Chief. Kasama din po namin sa TMDSS si Forrester Sinayda Reyes, si Ma'am Margie Dizon, Forrester Jeriel Espayuan, Forrester Jennifer Arcebuche, at si Forrester Christian Amante. Kami pong lahat ang tutulong sa inyo para sa lahat ng pangangailangan nyo sa training nito at especially po dun sa mga certificates na kakailanganin nyo sa amin sa pag-attend sa training na ito. At para naman po ipakilala sa inyo ang ating resource person for today, ikinalulugod ko pong ipakilala sa inyo ang isang expert po namin sa napakaraming technologies dito sa FERDI. Pero sa araw na po ito, magpo-focus po siya sa ating engineered bamboo. Ang ating pong resource person ay nagtapos ng BS Forest Products Engineering and Master of Science in Forestry sa UP Los Baños. Nagtapos din po siya ng Doctor in Philosophy on Resource Management and Environmental Science sa The Australian University. Siya po ay naging OIC ng Material Science Division natin, naging OIC din po ng Office of the Deputy Director. Sa kasalukuyan po, siya ang aming Division Chief sa Technology Innovation Division. Without further ado, let us all welcome to give us lecture on our training webinar Level 1 on Engineered Bamboo Production. Please welcome Dr. Rico J. Cabangon.
Thank you, Jason. Good morning po sa ating lahat. Sana tayo ay nasa mabuting kalagayan sa mga panahong ito. I would just like to do my presentation. I'll just share it now. Hello, good morning po ulit. Welcome to our training webinar on engineered bamboo production. Maraming salamat po sa pag-attend. We are well represented from Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. So this morning, this will be about engineered bamboo production. The lecture will be around a bit more than 30 minutes, and the rest of the time we can interrupt and answer your questions. So without further ado, let me go into the technology on engineered bamboo production. So, but before that, ito po yung ating objectives for this training webinar. First is we after the training, we will be able to understand what is engineered bamboo, its definition, its different types, enumerate the materials and machineries used for the production of engineered bamboo. You should be able to describe the production process and appreciate the applications of different engineered bamboo products. Okay? So first is to level off our webinar, our definition of engineered bamboo. Engineered bamboo is just a combination of different forms of bamboo, such as strands, slats, or particles, fibers, veneers, woven mats, or crushed or flattened bamboo, with an adhesive to form a composite material designed to meet a specific end use. So it's quite a long definition, but in layman's term, it is just man-made. We call it man-made or manufactured bamboo. Why? Because naturally, bamboo comes as a pole, no? It is round, hollow inside. But because of engineering, we can make this round, hollow pole into different forms or shapes through engineering. So, yun lang pong ibig sabihin ng engineered bamboo. So, in an equation form, it is different forms of bamboo plus we use an adhesive or a glue, and with assembling these different forms and through the process of pressing, we can come up with a product called engineered bamboo. So it's actually a product because of engineering process. Okay, so engineered bamboo in the Philippines are used for construction. This photo here, it was taken in Bukidnon, in Valencia, Bukidnon. This is made of giant bamboo and an adhesive. No? So in this house, they use it for staircase and flooring and even furniture, door panels, and door jams. And then another major application of engineered bamboo is for furniture. The one being shown at the slide is a picture at the Philippine Council for Agriculture, Aquatic and Natural Resources Research and Development, or PICARD, wherein engineered bamboo is used as a bench furniture. So that is made of Hawaiian tinik and bolo, I think, and produced into engineered bamboo benches. The flooring is also engineered bamboo. And then for handicrafts, we can also make use of engineered bamboo for handicrafts. The photo being shown in the slide is designed by the Design Center of the Philippines, and it is used as a magazine holder. So these are corrugated and laminated engineered bamboos, bamboo veneers, which is used for handicrafts. And another application of engineered bamboo is for the use of school desks and armchairs for public schools, in primary and secondary public schools. Wherein there's an executive order signed in 2010 requiring that 25% of the school desks and armchairs in public elementary and secondary schools should be made of bamboo. And we can only make those furnitures if we make the round bamboos into engineered bamboo. That is Executive Order 879. And with this executive order, the Philippine Bamboo Industry Development Council was also formed. So PBIDC is a council made up of different government agencies and non-government organizations and private organizations as well, wherein they plan and program the different activities to upgrade the initiatives on bamboo in the country. So in that executive order, all government furniture and fixtures should also be made of bamboo. So if we are looking for a market for engineered bamboo, this is one sure market. School desks and armchairs and other government furnitures and fixtures. Okay, so having said that, ano po ba yung mga different forms of bamboo that we can use for the production of engineered bamboo? As we have defined, it is forms of bamboo plus glue equals engineered bamboo. So ito po yung normal na ginagamit ngayon sa Philippines, although there are still other forms of bamboo that we can make for the production of engineered bamboo. But these ones are the commonly used materials or forms of bamboo for engineered bamboo production in the country. So we first, pinakamaraming ginagamit ay yung slats. No? So yung slats are parang sticks. And yun pong nakalagay po dyan ay strips, no? Because in the international standard, strips po ang tawag sa slats na tinatawag natin. So para hindi lang po tayo malito, no? Because pag meron tayong siguro kausap na taga-ibang bansa, they would call it strips. But sa Philippines, we call it slats. So para alam natin yung differentiation in the law. But they are the same. Okay? So, and then we can also make use of veneers, no? Woven mats, yung hinabi na mga strands ng bamboo, and then flattened or crushed bamboo, which I will deal in more detail later. Okay, having the different forms of materials for engineered bamboo production, may iba-iba pong tawag doon sa different forms of engineered bamboo. Okay. So yung if we will use slats or strips, we call it laminated bamboo slats or strips. Okay, so by definition, it's just you laminating these different slats, no, or strips. So ito pong slats or strips can be edge and or face glued. Okay. So ibig sabihin, if it is edge glued, yung pong smaller area noong slats, ayun po ang idinidikit. So pag idinikit mo po yung dalawang smaller surface area, ay yun po ang edge gluing. And then yung face naman po, yung face glued would be the larger surface area. Okay? So you can both edge and face glue. Is place face glue yung ating engineered bamboo from slats. So normally, if you will produce multi-layer engineered bamboo, you need to glue it both in the edge and face of the slats or strips. So yan, pwede po natin gawing single or multi-layer itong engineered bamboo from slats. So that picture there, the engineered bamboo, it's supposed to be an executive chair. As you can see, pwede tayong, because we said that it is already engineered, we use engineering to produce these different forms of engineered bamboo. We can make bent materials that we can design our furniture using these different forms. So sa furniture kasi, it would depend on the material and the design. Plus finishing, yun po yung nagdadala sa furniture. So because we are dealing with engineered bamboo, we can make any form or any shape that we like. Okay? So another form is yung flattened or crushed bamboo. So we call it laminated, flattened, or crushed bamboo. So the flattened or crushed bamboo are normally face glued only. Bihira yung nag-e-edge glue, no? Kasi because they are flattened or crushed. So normally these are produced in multi-layer engineered bamboos because it's hard to create or make an engineered bamboo if it's engineered bamboo from flattened or crushed bamboo if it's only single layer. Mahirap pong idikit yun. So it's usually multi-layer. And in your photo is in the photo in the slide is a picture of the flattened or crushed bamboo, and then the produced engineered bamboo table. So that was made in Negros Oriental. So another form is the veneer. So we call it laminated bamboo veneer. Right? So because it is very thin, ang veneer po is a thin piece of, ang bamboo veneer po is a very thin piece of bamboo na produced using a rotary lathe. So, kaya normally they are produced via face gluing. So, face glued lang po lahat ng engineered bamboo from veneers. So, ito pong, and it is multi-layer. Always multi-layer. Okay, so, ito pong engineered bamboo veneer na nakikita niyo po sa ating slide. It was designed by the Design Center of the Philippines. And yan po ay isang egg tray. Ano? So, it's a high-end egg tray. So, it is made up of different layers of bamboo veneers. Okay, so, as you can see, it is corrugated, no? So, para pag when you put the egg in the, ano, it will not touch the surface of the table or any surface. So, yan po ay corrugated. Because it's engineered, we can do any form of lamination. Okay, and then, we can also produce laminated woven mats, which is also a type of engineered bamboo. So, marami pong nag-weave sa atin sa buong Pilipinas. No? So, we can make use of that woven bamboo mats, glue them together by face gluing, and it's normally produced in multi-layer. So, if you would imagine a plywood, ang plywood po is made of veneers, wooden veneers. So, they are face glued or face laminated to produce the plywood we are using. It's very common to use plywood in our furniture or in construction. So, ganun din po ito, yung veneer tsaka itong woven mats, parang plywood din po yan, na yung ating mga materials like bamboo and woven mats are face glued together to form a panel product. Okay? So, ito pong nasa picture ngayon ay made of laminated woven mats and used as walls. But it can also be used for ceiling and other applications. We are also looking into this as a roofing material, a corrugated engineered bamboo as roofing material. But hindi pa po namin inalabas yan dahil we still have to do more research on that. Okay? So most of the problems in the production of engineered bamboo ay hindi natin nasusunod yung ating mga basic techniques or processes in producing engineered bamboo. So if in the slide you can see there are two furnitures. One is the corner table, the round one, and one is the school desk and armchairs. They both look good, no? But yung isa was properly processed, yung isa is not properly processed. No? If you will see in the lower itong armchair, no? So you will see merong mga discolorations in between the different slots or strips. May discoloration siya. So this one is attacked by stain, kaya medyo maitim siya, no? And this one also. And as well as on the seat part. So you will not see that in this corner table here. Maganda yung kanyang, almost uniform yung kanyang slots in terms of color or discoloration. So, wala siyang masyadong discoloration. So, this one is meron. So, in engineered bamboo, grades for engineered bamboo, this one would be grade A, and this one might fall into grade B, no, because of the discoloration. So, meron pong effect yon if there are stains in our engineered bamboo. Plus, if it is not properly glued or there are gaps, yun, magkakaroon ng effect dun sa magiging grade ng ating na-produce na engineered bamboo. Okay? So what do we do? We need to do the process, the proper processing techniques. So from pole harvesting, when we have the poles, if we will not yet produce it into engineered bamboo or we will not yet process that immediately, we need prophylactic treatment. We will discuss that later. So itong prophylactic treatment na to para maiwasan natin yung mga stains na yun. So that could have been the problem kung bakit nagkaroon ng stain yung ating engineered bamboo school chair. So that might be the cause, no? And then we process, if we make it into slats, mats, or flattened bamboo or veneer, and then we dry. So drying is also an important process in engineered bamboo, because if not, pag pinabayaan po natin na siya ay hindi tuyo, again, the stains, the fungi, and other insects can attack the bamboo. And then proper gluing, assembly, we assemble the forms together, and then we press. So ang pressing po ay very important part ng bamboo processing, because it is where the boards are produced. And what it would the press, the size of the press ay dun po magbe-base kung gaano kalaki yung ating mapoproduce na engineered bamboo. Okay? And then we do finishing like trimming, molding if required. Ito pong molding, ito yung parang nagagawa tayo ng tongue and groove sa edges para mapagdikit natin yung dalawang engineered bamboo. And then if we need final treatment before we finish, we apply the finishes. And then we store or deliver our products. So yan po yung general production process, but we will go into that in more detail. Okay. So normally, ang poles na ginagamit for engineered bamboo production are Kawayan tinik, okay, Bolo. Bolo, marami po niyan dito sa Laguna, sa Region 4, and maybe Region 5. Kawayan tinik is all over the country. And you cannot, hindi nyo ma-alien, lagi nyo ma-identify agad yung Kawayan tinik dahil sa presence of thorns or tinik. Yung Bolo, you will recognize Bolo because of the, sa ilalim niya ay merong mga parang Bolo, yung makati, no? Sa ilalim ng dahon ng Bolo bamboo. And then yung giant bamboo, it will not be called giant bamboo if it's not big, no? So it can go a diameter of around 1 foot. And marami po niyan ay sa Bukidnon and in Benguet. So we observe that giant bamboos grow well in climates, no? And medyo elevated. And then Bayog is very popular in the northern part of the Philippines. But ang Bayog has the tendency to tumiko o mag-curve during its growing years. So if we will use Bayog, we have to get the straight Bayog poles. And of course, maraming pa diyang introduced na species like Guadua, at marami pa pong iba. So we just need to select the proper materials for engineered bamboo production. And then there are three different types of glue that we can use. First, yung polyvinyl acetate, or ito po yung white glue. But the white glue being used here is not the the type we use for papers. No, we need to use the grade 3 polyvinyl acetate. So it has a higher D3 grade polyvinyl acetate because it has a higher moisture resistance. And then we also can make use of urea and phenyl formaldehyde. So yung urea is white in color, but pag nag-set siya, it will be colorless. Yung phenol is reddish-brown in color, and when it sets, it's also reddish-brown in color. So if we will make furnitures out of engineered bamboo, mas magandang gamitin yung colorless glue. So ito po ay mga locally available glues which we can buy in depots and the urea and phenol formaldehyde, we have to buy it from suppliers or manufacturers. So, harvesting. Siguro tinatanong natin, ano ba ang kailangan nating pool? Or kailan tayo mag-harvest ng pool? So, we need at least 3-year-old pool, no, for engineered bamboo production, because at this age, ang bamboo po ay matured na. So, at least 3-year-old po dapat. And then, it should be straight and thick-walled. No? So, para lalo na kung magagawa tayo ng slats and veneers and even flattened bamboo, crushed bamboo, kailangan natin ay diretso, straight and thick-walled. So, ang kailangan po dyan ay makapal yung wall ng ating bamboo so that we can have higher yield if we produce it into engineered bamboo. And then, kailan ba dapat mag-harvest? Meron tayong tinatawag na taga sa panahon. So, yung taga sa panahon ay okay po yun, kaya lang hindi naman lagi dapat susundin natin yan dahil we are producing, lalo na if we want to export engineered bamboo, dapat we can harvest anytime as appropriate. Ibig sabihin, as appropriate, huwag naman kung bumabagyo ay mag-harvest pa rin tayo. So basta it is safe to harvest, it is okay to harvest anytime. So just to give you an idea yung sa taga sa panahon, no? One of our researchers, si Dr. Carlos Garcia, did an experiment on the to prove the taga sa panahon. No? So, meron siyang correlation between the starch content, time of the year, month of the year, and population of beetles. No? So, during the summer months, mataas po ang starch content ng kawayan. So, this might be due to the higher amount of sunlight during this time. So, marami yung kanyang starch content because yun yung food for the bamboo. So, inulit niya yan sa different years. No? So, the same pattern. Every summer months ay mataas ang starch content, and it is related to the amount of beetles in the area or in the plantation. No? So there is a correlation. So ibig sabihin, yung taga sa panahon ay dapat during the, not in the summer months. May sinasabi nila during burr months. No? So this is the time na mababa ang starch content at saka mababa ang population ng beetles. So ang importante po dito ay pag nag-harvest tayo ng ganung time, ay mas kukunti yung ating baka pwede tayong makaiwas sa treatment. But we always recommend treatment of bamboo to make sure that it will not be attacked by biodeteriorating agents. So harvest anytime po as appropriate. So ito po yung sinasabi nating prophylactic treatment. So after harvesting, we need to administer mild treatment. Okay? So immediately after harvesting. Kapag hindi pa natin ipoporous agad yung ating kawayan, kapag itatambak pa natin siya or i-store pa natin siya before we will use it, we have to do prophylactic treatment. So para maiwasan yung pagpasok ng bukbok, yung mga stains and fungi and molds. No? So, ito pong prophylactic treatment, pinapahid lang natin or ini-spray sa mga cut ends or mga sugat ng ating poles. So, but in terms of veneering and flattening, dapat as much as possible after harvesting, ay ma-process natin agad siya. Kasi kailangan doon medyo basa pa yung kawayan so that we can easily produce the veneers and flatten bamboo. Okay? So, ito po yung pag-prepare ng materials using slabs or sticks. So, you need a pole cutter. Ito pong pole cutter, yung nasa picture dyan. Or cross-cut saw or manual saw, yung carpenter saw. So, kung wala po tayong pole cutter, pwede namang mano-mano using an ordinary carpenter saw. And then, that is to cut the lengths of the poles. No? And then, we produce it into slots. So, dito po, hindi pwedeng mano-mano. Kailangan po talaga ay meron tayong makina to produce the slots. We use the twin rip saw. Because if we use the twin rip saw, pare-pareho na po ang width na makukuha natin to produce the slots. Okay? So, when we have the slots produced by the twin rip saw, we now remove the nodes and the diaphragm of the bamboo. So, pwede po yung makina, denoder or diaphragm remover, or pwedeng mano-mano using a bolo, tatanggalin lang natin yung kanyang buko at saka tiyan. Okay? So, sa flattened bamboo, again, we have to, because bamboo is a very long pole, we need to cut the poles into lengths. No? So, after that, pwede na natin siyang i-flatten or crush if we will use the manual process. But if we will use a flattening machine, we need to split and boil in a vat yun pong ating bamboo before we flatten. So dito po sa flattening machine ay hindi tinataga yung kawayan, basta pinapasok lang siya dito sa ating machine. And then, dahan-dahan po yung bubuka at magiging na siyang flattened bamboo. So, sa ano po kasi, sa manual flattening, minsan nagiging more on crushed bamboo na siya kasi may mga taga. So, yun po yung difference noong flattened and using manual process and flattening machine. And of course, with flattening machine, because you're dealing with you're using a machine, mas mabilis po ang production at hindi basta-basta napapagod ang makina, hindi katulad ng sa tao na manual process. So, siguro sa umaga, malakas ka pa, marami ka pang magagawang flattened or crushed bamboo. But pagdating sa hapon, medyo pagod ka na, bumabagal na yung efficiency. Pero sa flattening machine, as long as the machine is in good condition, mas mabilis po tayo makagawa ng flattened bamboo. And this is important if we have to produce at least 200 flattened bamboo in a day. So yung pong production ng veneer ay, again, you need a cross-cut saw, a pole cutter, and then we boil it again because we have to soften the fibers. And then the boiled bamboo is subjected to is fed to the rotary bamboo veneer lathe. So it is a special veneer lathe, specifically for bamboo. So, yun pong ating isang cross-cut na pole or billet, it can be produced into 10 feet or more na bamboo veneer. Okay? Using the bamboo veneer. Again, kailangan po talaga natin dito ng makina to produce the veneers. Hindi po kaya ng mano-mano na gawin ang bamboo veneers. Okay? And then yung mats ay kailangan din natin ng cross-cut saw, and then we manually produce it into strands, no? And then we weave. So far, sa Philippines, all these are made manually. Okay. So lahat po yan manual pa ngayon, which is, to a certain extent, is advantageous for our communities. Para it would be more labor-intensive, we can organize different communities to be involved in the production of mats for engineered bamboo production. Okay? So once we have the materials of different forms, pare-pareho na po ang procedure. So naihanda na natin yung slots, veneers, flattened bamboo, or crushed bamboo. And after that, we need to dry. So we have a technology called the furnace type kiln dryer. And we can also use air drying. So we have to lower down the moisture content of the bamboo to a certain level, depending on the press we will use. So for cold pressing, if we use PVAC or polyvinyl acetate, we can lower it down to 15% to 18%. But if you will use urea formaldehyde or phenolformaldehyde glues, we have to lower down the moisture content to at most 12%, okay? 6% to 12%. Okay, so and then we have to plane the slats and the flattened bamboo. Yun lang po ang ating ipi-planer, slats and flattened bamboo. And using a thickness planer, okay, so, and or a six-side smolder, yung nasa left side na picture. Okay. And then once we have the materials dried, we can now apply glue. Okay. So pag maliit lang po yung ating ginagawa, actually itong engineered bamboo can also be a hobby kung gusto po natin. If we are a hobbyist, we can also produce engineered bamboo for our hobbies, no? For making small items. So kung small item yung ginagawa mo, you can use a glue spreader, a roller. You can use a roller, glue roller. Or if we are in an industrial scale, we need a glue spreader, as you can see in the picture. And then after that, we press yung ating glued bamboo. We press it either cold pressing or hot pressing. So sa cold pressing, medyo matagal dahil we have to set the glue for around 4 to 6 hours or even overnight. While in hot pressing, you can produce engineered bamboo within 5 minutes. So meron po siyang mga different advantages and disadvantages depending on the glue we are using. So if you use cold setting glue, oh, hindi mo kailangan ng hot press because hot press would require higher energy, higher electricity, pero you can produce more in a day. So we have to balance this different inputs in making our engineered bamboo. So for cold pressing, we can use laminating press. Or for hot pressing, we can use glue laminating press. Or cold, or it can be hot press or cold pressing. So yung laminating press po na yan, we can use wider and longer surface areas. So sa table press or clamps, usually ang napoproduce natin dyan ay longer lang. Hindi masyadong wide because mahirap mag-press if it is too wide using the table press or clamps. So if you will use like yung mga paa ng lamesa or paa ng furniture, we can make use of this table press or clamps. Pero if we will produce wide products, we should use the glue laminating press. So ito po ay ginagamit, yung glue laminating press, yung nasa left side, it is used for bamboo veneers and woven mats. And also for strips and basta yung wider surfaces. And then once we have produced our engineered bamboo, we have to check the width and the length. So we use an end trimming machine or radial arm saw for the length. And then for the edges, we can make use of the table saw for edge trimming. Then to make sure that we have good surfaces, we use a wide belt sander before finishing. Okay? So if we still want final treatment, we can do final treatment or pwedeng hindi naman. And or after treatment, we can already use finishing, whatever choice of finish you want. No? So ang maganda po dyan, we can use brush, pero if we want high quality product, it is better to use an air compressor kasi talagang evenly distributed yung finishes using an air compressor, air finishing. And then we can also make use of finishing spray booth. We have also technology on finishing spray booth to collect the spray, yung sobrang spray, if we use air spray doon sa ating engineered bamboo. Okay? So, yun po ang kabuuan ng ating background and information about engineered bamboo and the process, no, and the different materials. So, doing the right process means we will have higher product quality. So, yun, nakita po natin kaya na may mga different stains. Mawawala po yun if we produce it at the right process, using the right process. And of course, if we're into manufacturing, because of the higher product quality, we can have higher, we can command higher price. And no back job. Okay? So, kasi kuminsan, if you will, kung mapapansin nyo yung mga different furniture products, we can, bamboo furniture, we can see in the highways, no, along the roads or at the side of the roads or highways. Usually, hindi pa masyadong dried yung ating bamboo na ginagamit nila. So, when that happens, it can be attacked by bukbok because it is not yet dried. Ay, yung stains can come in, yung fungi creating the stains will come in, and then yung if it is not yet properly dried, nagsishrink pa yun habang ginagamit mo. So, mapapansin nyo, lumuluwag yung kanyang mga joints. So, in that case, back job yun. The customer might bring back the item and you have to do to solve what the problem is. So no back job if we do the right process. And of course, customers keep coming back if we have the right process. So ganun din po if you want to use this training as a hobby. So pwede rin po yan. Pero syempre, magandang quality yung pay yung gagawin. So that ends my presentation. Thank you again for attending this Engineered Bamboo Training webinar. And I hope you learned something this morning and I can entertain questions after this presentation. Thank you very much. Good morning again.
Thank you very much, Dr. Rico, for your comprehensive presentation on the fundamentals of engineered bamboo production. Before we proceed to our Q&A portion, basta question and answer po natin, our open forum, we would like to remind po our group viewers na to make sure that all of you are officially registered sa ating training webinar na to, and each of you should accomplish our training evaluation form, which will be pasted on our chat box. Ayan na po, andyan na po yung ating training evaluation link. Muli po, paalala po sa lahat, sa overall rating po natin, ang kailangan po natin ay numerical rating from 1 to 5, with 5 being the highest. At tatanggapin din po namin yung mga may decimal points, gaya ng 4.75, 4.95 na ratings. Okay lang po yun. Feel free to rate us honestly so we will know how to improve our next edition of our training webinar. Huwag po kayong mahihiya na ibigay yung tamang rating para sa ating training na to. At paalala po uli, kahit ulit-ulit nating sinasabi dito, yung pong complete name nyo and email address. Bakit po? To make sure na tama po yung ating ipe-prepare na certificates at para po may padala namin sa inyo ang e-certificate. So yun lang po, complete name and email addresses, lalong-lalo na po sa ating mga group viewers, and we understand na marami po sa atin ang sama-samang nag-view ngayon para maiwasan yung ating internet jamming. So, with that po, dahil tayo po ay nasa panahon pa ng pandemya ngayon, at kaya po tayo, ang platform natin ngayon ay training webinar, mahalaga po na manatili tayong malusog at ligtas at masaya sa panahong ito. With this po, ipapakita po namin ang ilang COVID-19 safety reminders while we are collecting our questions. Pwede na po kayong magpadala ng questions sa ating chat box. Lahat po ng questions na i-entertain namin ay yun lang pong manggagaling sa ating chat box. So while the video on COVID-19 safety reminders is being played, pakilagay na po sa chat box ang inyong mga comments, questions, and anything you want to know more about engineered bamboo production. pagkatapos ng presentation na yon, we will start entertaining as many questions as we can. At doon naman po sa hindi namin maisama sa live webinar na to, yung mga questions, make sure po na i-chat niyo pa rin sa ating comment box para po siguradong masasagot namin ang mga tanong niyo tungkol sa engineered bamboo production. With that, Ma'am Chen, our COVID-19 safety reminders, please. Hello, good morning po ulit sa ating mga participants. Welcome to our open forum portion of our training webinar. Ang una po nating katanungan ay tungkol sa ano po, saan po makukuha ang... Teka po, pasensya na ho at nag... Umandar po yung ating chat box, pasensya na ho. Saglit lang po. Ito po muna habang hinahanap ko yung ating unang question kanina. Ito po, Doc Rico. How many e-bamboo producers are there in the country?
Okay, there are marami po, no? Maraming producers ng engineered bamboo. It can range from micro scale to large scale. So yun po mga micro scale, hindi namin masyadong mo-monitor. But there are many manufacturers from Luzon to Mindanao. No? So yun pong, ang alam pong active na napupuntahan ko ay yung nasa dalawa sa Pangasinan, one is in Bayambang and one is in Alaminos. I think the one in Lubao, Pampanga is also operating. And there are more. You can actually contact the Department of Trade and Industry kasi they have given many shared service facilities for engineered bamboo production. Hindi po namin masyadong namo-monitor yun. It's more on the DTI who is monitoring those production. But on my personal capacity, I talked with different manufacturers. Yun lang po yung aking sasabi na actively producing. But there are many plants in the Philippines because of the SSF. And of course, DOST is also have common service facilities all over the country, just with our set-up program.
Ito po, dun po sa ating mga participants, please let us know po kung nagkakaroon tayo ng problema sa pag-fill up ng ating evaluation form, kung meron kayong hassles na encounter sa pag-accomplish nun. So ilagay lang din po natin yun sa ating chat box. Ito po yung next question natin, Doc Rico, from Ms. Miriam Mondia. Good morning. May we know if we have the supplier for kiln dryer for bamboo in Mindanao? If possible, we have a client here na nangangailangan po ng kiln dryer.
Yung pong kiln dryer is, we have the technology at FPRDI. So I would recommend that you send us an email requesting for either requesting for information or actually getting technical assistance for the kiln dryer. And we will be the one to determine the fabricators that we can recommend. Depende kung saan po sa Mindanao.
Okay, ito po, next question, sir. From Ms. Gil David. How big is the price difference today between engineered bamboo versus alternative plastic products and wood products from abroad available locally? Ulitin ko, sir. Okay na po, sir.
Wala akong cost comparison between the plastic or yung mga resin resin-based composites. But ang advantage lang na if you use bamboo is we are dealing with a regenerative material, environment-friendly material compared with plastics. Pero as of today, I don't have the cost comparison between those two materials. But of course, they have different properties. The main advantage of using bamboo is that it's more environment friendly than the plastics.
Ito po, next question from Passion for Vayor. Where can we have the bamboo produce engineered into an actual product? Where can we have the bamboo produce engineered into an actual product? Malinaw po ba yung tanong?
Baka ikaw pwede sumagot ng Jason.
Where can we have the bamboo produce into an actual product? Kami po ay may mga kasunod pang trainings dito sa FPRDI. Kung gusto niyo pong matuto kung paano mag-produce ng actual product from engineered bamboo, please wait for our announcement on that training. So abangan niyo na lang po para po sa ating mga kasamahan sa Passion for Vayor, abangan niyo na lang po yung aming training webinar on that subject. Sana po nasagot namin ng maayos yan mula sa Passion for Vayor. Ito pa hong tanong, ano po bang ginagamit na instrument para malaman natin ang moisture content ng bamboo? Yan po yung kauna-unang question na hinahanap ko kanina. So maraming salamat po kay Dr. G for finding that question. Yan po ang isang tanong, Dr. Rico.
Okay, we also have a locally made moisture meter. It is being produced in the Philippines. So ang maganda po dito sa moisture meter na ito, it is, since it is locally made, ay calibrated po sa ating mga kahoy. We can use it for wood as well as bamboo. So it is calibrated to our local wood and bamboo species. And most of the moisture meters are imported. So now that we have our own, madali na yung after sale service, kung may problema yung ating moisture meter, they can supply the spare parts or they can repair the moisture meter easily. Hindi natin kailangan kunin from abroad. So, mura lang po itong moisture meter na ito. It's a digital type moisture meter, resistance type moisture meter. It costs around 5,500 pesos only. So, pwede po dito sa opisina, you can order here, or pwede rin sa main supplier sa Quiapo area.
Kung mag-i-invest po for e-bamboo production, saan po pwedeng makabili ng mga equipment and how much po yung cost? Thank you. That's question now ay galing kay Mr. Oliver Marasigan.
Okay. Yung mga equipment we have today are mostly imported, but we also have our own locally fabricated machinery. So it can be a combination of imported and locally produced machineries or all imported machineries. So, but of course, we wanted to promote our locally made machines para hindi na tayo maglalabas sa mga dollar reserves, no? So bumili na lang natin yung wala tayo dito sa Pilipinas. That's my recommendation in terms of machineries.
From Mr. Salige William, ano po ang recommended chemical na gagamitin sa time ng prophylactic treatment sa bamboo?
Okay, so hindi ko po talaga sinabi kung ano yung brand, no, because we are not endorsing any brand. But you can go into a depot or a hardware, just look for a chemical that can be used for wood. Alam na po natin yan, yung mga different chemicals na we use for wood, no? So, pwede rin pong gamitin yan sa kawayan. So, yung prophylactic treatment ay it's a mild treatment. So, kung ang nakalagay dun sa ating label ng chemicals na binili natin ay, let's say, 1:10 or 1:100 ang ratio ng water to the chemical, pwede po nating doblehin or 50% noon ay yun lang po yung ating timpla. So it's a prophylactic treatment. It's just an initial treatment. So hindi kailangang mataas yung concentration. So ganun lang po yun. Punta lang po tayo sa hardware and look for a chemical for wood. No? We can also use for bamboo. Ngayon, kung gusto niyo po yung chemical na ano, email niyo po ako. Email po kayo sa amin. Kasi ako sasabihin sa inyo, huwag po dito sa...
Okay na sir, sorry for interrupting you. Ito po, another question from Ms. Perlita Corfuz. Any plans of using plant-based glue?
Oh, at this time, yung mga plant-based glues ay still very expensive if we will develop that. And even after we commercialize that, medyo mataas yung cost. Actually, ang glue po ay noong unang panahon ay gawa sa plant-based materials. But because it is not as durable as the synthetic glues, mas marami ang pinoproduce na glues ngayon. So, of course, we can make use of plant-based materials or even animal-based glues. Pero yun po kasing performance ng these types of glues is hindi ganun kabisa katulad ng mga synthetic glues that we have today. But kung magdidikit lang po tayo ng papel, halimbawa, or yung simple lang na pagdidikit, we can make use of plant-based glues. Pero pag sa construction for furniture, kailangan talaga medyo high strength yung ating and water resistant.
Okay, sir. Thanks again for your patience sa mga questions ng ating mga participants. Ito pong isa pang tanong. Ano po ang mas okay in terms of quality using kiln drying or air drying po? Ano po ang mas maganda and preferred process po for better output? Thank you po, from Bea Hunsai.
We recommend the kiln drying method. It is mas sigurado tayo na yung moisture content na gusto nating abutin ay maaabot and mas mabilis. No? Mas mabilis natin magagawa yung moisture content, mapapababa ang moisture content if we use the kiln dryer. So, but of course, because we are using a dryer or a facility, merong investment involved. Hindi katulad sa air drying na it's free. Air is free, the sunlight is free, humidity is free, but we cannot control our drying process. So with the kiln dryer, we can control, we can do drying even if it's raining. So yun po yung advantage ng kiln dryer. So again, we have to balance yung ating inputs depende kung ano ang ating gustong product or market. But if we are going into export, it's really needed na we have to use the clean dryer. Kasi pag mataas ang moisture, they will not accept our product.
Ito po ho, from Mr. Carl Von Lin Corrada. Hindi ko po alam kung nasagot na ng bagyato kanina ni Doc Rico, pero itatanong pa rin po natin. May we know the equipment specifics for production po para sa engineered bamboo? Thank you po.
Ano, Jason?
Ito po. May we know the equipment specifications for production?
Oh, specification.
Carbon din. Yes.
So, yung specifications po, we really have to bigay yung detalye niyan. So, hindi ko po pwedeng i-present yun kanina because hindi naman, we don't have the luxury of time. But you just send us an email and we will give you specifications or we can recommend you to suppliers of engineered bamboo machineries.
Hello, sir. Kaya pa? Can we still more questions, sir? Okay lang po ba?
Marami po ba? Kung kukunti na lang, okay lang.
Sige po. Mukhang konti na lang naman, sir. Pero para po sa ating mga participants, para makapagpahinga naman po si Doc Rico ng konti, yung pong ating evaluation form, we have 3 days po as posted, as played during sa ating mechanics and house rule. Meron po kayong 3 days para makomplete nyo yung evaluation form. Kapag hindi nyo po yan natapos sa itinakdang araw para matapos yung evaluation form, eh hindi po kayo makakakuha ng ating certificate of participation. So make sure lang po, at kung magagawa nyo na after this training webinar, isend nyo na po agad sa amin na inyong evaluation form. So yun lang po yung mahalagang reminders para sa ating mga participants. Doc Rico, another question from Ms. Perlita Corpus. Ito po, EOAs. EO-879 may have required public schools and government offices. I think maybe few or close to none have followed this due to high cost. Ito po ay tungkol sa production ng engineered bamboo para sa ating ano, Department of Education. Baka yun ang tinutukan yung mga corpus, sir.
Yeah, actually, yung mga unang na-produce na engineered bamboo for school desk and armchairs, medyo mataas yung cost, no? So it would depend on the area where you're producing the engineered bamboo because hindi, walang standard cost ang bamboo. For different regions, iba-iba yung cost ng bamboo. But in certain places, mataas. In certain places, mura. So, but generally, tama yung sinasabi ni Ma'am Perlix. But ang ginawa ng PBIDC and DepEd, they increased the cost or the buying cost of school desk or armchairs, I think to 1,000 pesos per piece. So dati yun ay 700. But just to give support to the bamboo industry, they have increased the buying cost for purchasing cost for engineered bamboo for school desk and armchairs.
Hello, sir. From Michael Montes, any idea po ng fire rating ng engineered bamboo, if meron?
Yung fire rating, kasi suspended yung aming fire rating services ngayon. But we will look into that, no? Kasi for the building codes, we will look into the fire rating of our locally produced engineered bamboo, even raw bamboo forms. Ang maganda kasi sa bamboo because it has silica content. Hindi siya basta-basta mag-i-ignite. But, and hindi siya nagpumumot ng, of course, siyempre, unless it will be laging merong naka-ambang na apoy. No? But generally, kung ignition lang, tsaka flammability, hindi siya ganon because of the silica content within the bamboo. But we will look into that, no? Yung ating local bamboo species and engineered bamboo for to determine their fire resistance.
Hello po. I think we are just down to a few questions. And before that, we would like to flash yung level 2 ng training webinar natin dito sa Engineered Bamboo Production. So bago po natin itanong yun, panoorin po muna natin itong aming announcement para sa level 2 ng training webinar on Engineered Bamboo Production. So ayan po yung ating announcement. Abangan nyo rin po yan sa ating official FB page ng DOST-FBRDI para po makasali ulit kayo sa next training natin on Engineered Bamboo. Ito po, next question po. Aside from DOST-FBRDI, what other government agencies have programs on bamboo, not necessarily on Engineered Bamboo? Sir, as member of ating Bamboo Council.
Actually, all the agencies that are members of the Philippine Bamboo Industry Development Council have programs, no? Including Department of Agriculture, Department of Environment Natural Resources in terms of plantation establishments or nursery establishments. Yung DA, they have this program on high-value crops. So bamboo is considered as a high-value crop in the Department of Agriculture. DNR, and then of course DOST, we have different programs, training programs like this, and of course technical assistance. Ang FBRDI po, wala masyadong financial assistance, but our mother agency, the Department of Science and Technology, has a program on set up. Pwede silang magpa-utang nang walang interest and negotiable kung hanggang kailan yung mabayaran. And we also have TAPI, yung joint venture, also TAPI, yung joint venture. And then DTI, they also have a program on bamboo, yung mga shared service facility. Ang DTI actually yung lead agency in the Philippine Bamboo Industry Development Council. So DepEd also, of course, because of the school desk and armchairs. And DOLE, they also have programs on bamboo. They will support our bamboo programs, lalo na sa mga returning overseas workers. They will they have funds for returning overseas workers. So, yun po yung mga agencies. I might have left someone, but generally, yun po yung mga different programs of the agencies as members of the PBIDC.
Thank you, sir. So, I hope those info nakatulong po sana yan sa ating participant na nagtanong na yan. Para po alam natin lahat, para mag-guide po tayong lahat sa training webinar nito, mag-entertain na lang po kami ng last three questions. So, mula po sa tanong na to, ay ito na ang ating third of the last question. Doc Rico, galing po to kay Mr. Teodulo Quijada. We are using the borix and boric acid by boiling treatment. Can we use the malatayon mix with water without boiling process para po mas maging mabilis ang treatment process?
Yeah, yun pong boiling is already a form of treatment. Kasi if you would notice pag nag-boil kayo, you will leach out the starch inside the bamboo. So when we leach out the starch, nawawala po yung pagkain ng bukbok. No? So, and we know that bukbok is the number one enemy of bamboo. So if we leach out the food of the bukbok, it's also already a form of treatment. But of course, we can make use of borax or boric acid for that. Yung malatayon, ay hindi po yan usually ginagamit. Iba po ang use ng malatayon, not for engineered bamboo treatment.
Thank you, sir. Para po sa ating mga participants, nagkakaroon din po tayo ng training webinar on preservation and treatment. Meron din po tayo noon sa wood and non-wood. So, sa bamboo po, At abangan niyo po, basta lagi lang po niyong tingnan ang aming DOST-FERDI official page. Tapos huwag niyo lang po tingnan, kung maaari po sana, i-like niyo na din para matulungan niyo kami. At yun lang po, ang ating last two questions to. Saglit lang po ha, at nadami ang ating chat. Saglit, pasensya na po. Meron pong tanong tungkol dun sa ano yung pinakamagandang gamitin kawayan. Doc, may binabanggit siyang buho, pero ano po ba ang ma-advise siya kung buho nga ba talaga ang pinakamagandang gamitin sa engineered bamboo?
Okay, so ang depende po no kung ano ang gusto nating final product. But for engineered bamboo, if you use it for furniture and construction, ang recommended po natin dyan ay tinik, Hawaiian tinik or giant bamboo, because they have the strength, they have the hardness that is required for furniture as well as for construction, such as for flooring, no? Kasi hindi dapat basta-basta nadedent yung ating flooring or furniture. So kaya kailangan natin strength and hardness. Kasi kung malambot ang ating flooring, laging meron yang madaling ma-scratch. Even at saka kung malambot yan, ay madali siyang ma-dent. So so far with the Hawaiian tinik and giant bamboo, maganda naman yung engineered bamboo na properties na nagagawa from those species. Although we can use other bamboo such as polo and bayog. As I mentioned earlier, kailangan yung bayog is straight. Depende po kung saan natin gagamitin. Kung gagawa tayong engineered bamboo for ceiling, pwede namang kahit yung malambot na kawayan ang gamitin natin. Actually, meron siyang advantage if it is less dense, because there are more air spaces between the cells of bamboo, and it makes it more insulating than the dense species.
Hello, sir. Bago po tayo mag-last question, meron tayong bonus question bago natin itanong yung huling question sa inyo. I-reserve po talaga namin yung last question na yun eh. Pero may maganda po kasing humabol na tanong. Galing kay Miss Gilmar Compok. When it comes to durability po, sir, of engineered bamboo products compared to its competitors, which is better po, sir?
Okay, so ang durability kasi, ang definition ng durability is how it would withstand different external forces, no? So yun yung definition ng durability, including time. You would expose it to the weather, so it's also a form of durability. So iba-iba yun, no? But if we will let's say durability in terms of its resistance to the weather or the environment, it would depend on the process we will use. So at this point, because basic yung ating presentation ngayon, it's level 1 production, meron kasing form of treatment for engineered bamboo called for bamboo, which is called the thermal modification process. Thermal modification process is a process wherein the bamboos are subjected to high temperature using steam or oil or other means, no, or other media. So ang ginagawa nito ay, with the high temperature, it changes the chemical composition of the bamboo, which makes it more resistant to different biodeteriorating agents. It makes it more stable, and it makes it more durable. Okay? So, yun pong mga nasa northern part ng Philippines, I don't know if you are aware of the Guinness Book of World Record na statue in Bayambang, Pangasinan. So, it is made of thermally modified bamboo. So, kaya po siya ay pwedeng gamitin outdoors because of this special treatment to the bamboo. And with that, we can make, use it for outdoors. And it is durable, actually very durable. So ito pong mga ganitong thermally modified bamboo products, we can make it, use it as decking or for outdoor furniture. So yun po ang durability ng bamboo. If you want to make it a very durable engineered bamboo product. So so yun po, in terms of durability, kasi yun yung more, I think, more exact application of durability in terms of bamboo. And comparing it to wood or other products, syempre, ganun pa rin po. If we thermally modified wood, it would have the same effect. So, but in terms of other materials, sinasabi ko nga po, of course, lalo may competitor yung bamboo material, but the main advantage of bamboo is that it is environment friendly. As long as you plant bamboo, you can harvest. Other non-regenerative materials, pag binina mo na o pinuha mo na, ay hindi mo na mababalik. But you can recycle, but hindi katulad ng bamboo na once you planted, you can have harvest every time or at different seasons.
Okay po. Now we are down to our last questions. But before that, make sure po na napilapan nyo na yung ating evaluation form. At nakapaglagay po tayo dito ng complete name and email address sa ating chat box. And for those who na gusto po pa hong magtanong at yung mga nagtanong po kanina na hindi po natin na isama dito sa live webinar, make sure lang po na ilagay nyo pa rin yun sa ating chat box. Lahat po ng questions na nasa chat box natin na hindi natin nasagot sa live training na to, we will attend to that and we will send it to you through email. At doon po sa mga may naisip na tanong at the course of our open forum, alam ko maraming lumabas na ideas sa palitan natin ng diskurso with Dr. Rico, i-send you lang po. We will keep our Google Meet meeting na to ng mga ilang minutes after this training para may send you po yung inyong mga tanong. At yun po, abangan nyo ang ating Level 2 training webinar sa Engineered Bamboo Production. And finally, sir, here is our last question for this training webinar from Mr. Carl Bon Lim Corada. May we know what is the lifespan of chair made from engineered bamboo?
Lifespan. Okay, sa ngayon lifespan, po, sir, ay hindi pa natin ma-determine yung lifespan kasi yung atin pong mga and armchairs are still being used, no? Hindi pa natin malaman kasi bago pa lang. But in terms of durability, no? Kasi yung po namang ating mga school desks and armchairs are used indoors. So they are furniture. So hindi siya exposed sa weather. So I think in terms of exposure to the different environment, ay safe po siya because it is his interior. So yun pong kanya namang properties in terms of serviceability, ay yun po naman ay tinetest muna sa aming opisina, sa FPRDI. We have a state-of-the-art furniture testing facility, and if the, let's say, the bidder or supplier of engineered bamboo for school desks and armchairs, they have to pass the tests. So yun pong test na ginagawa sa ating mga school desk and armchairs ay dumadaan po yan sa fatigue test, no? So sinisimulate niya yung inuupuan siya, sinasandalan, nirarak, binabagsak. So yun po ay dumadaan sa testing dito sa aming opisina. At hindi po makakapag-bid ang isang supplier kung hindi papasa dun sa test. So, but at this point, yung lifespan, hindi pa po natin masagot dahil bago pa lang itong paggamit ng engineered bamboo for school desks and armchairs. But katulad nga po na sinabi ko, hindi naman siya masyadong exposed sa environment and more on the use, no? More on the use of the product indoors. But they are being tested before they are, before the suppliers are can have the go signal to to supply to the Department of Education.
So maraming salamat, Doc Rico, for your patience and for indulging the pleasure of our participants na mag-entertain tayo ng mga extra questions. And thank you for serving us ng extended ngayong araw na to. At sa ating pong mga participants, yun po, abangan ang ating level 2 training ng Engineered Bamboo Production. At sir, may konti pang tawad bago namin kayo tuluyang bitawan. Hingi po kami ng last words para sa inyo kung ano po ba yung ginagawa ng ating opisina, hindi lang tungkol sa Engineered Bamboo. Ano po yung mga related na technologies or mga ginagawa nating initiatives ngayong panahon ng pandemya? So sir, along that line po, last message, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Yung nakita niyo po kanina yung pinresent na ni Sir Jason about our office. So we conduct research and development, we transport technologies, we conduct trainings and testing services, no? So lahat po yan, pwede kayo mag-avail sa aming office. But in terms of the initiatives in this time of pandemic, no? So we also have, first and foremost, one of our most popular technology during this pandemic, yung bamboo frame retractable face shield. No? So it's a very humble technology which our staff, our personnel have developed during the onset of the pandemic na kung paano makakatulong sa ating pandemic. So ngayon po, yung mga face shields ay kailangan na natin for minimum health standards. And marami po talagang nagre-request ng training on the bamboo frame face shield. So actually, the secretary has requested us to have a mass training on bamboo frame face shields because of the popularity of this technology which are being used now in these times. No? So maybe our director, Dr. Agangan, will kasi kasasabi lang po ni secretary. So maybe Dr. Agangan will inform the group of Doc Jill and Sir Jason about this mass training for bamboo frame face shield. So abangan nyo din po yun. So we also have this different technologies on soaps, sa paggawa ng soaps using bamboo and other non-wood forest products. So we use it as activated charcoal and scents for soaps and hand mist. So in different products from the forest. So at this point, we have produced prototypes using these different materials. So para makatulong din sa ating mga minimum health standards in washing our hands and applying hand mist sa ating hands to combat COVID-19. And we are also looking into the use of bamboo for different applications such as for hands-free, yung paggamit mo ng, let's say, alcohol, disinfectants, na hindi mo kailangan hawakan yung bottle. So it's hands-free dispenser for these different alcohol-based disinfectants. So marami pa po, marami pa kaming pwedeng gawin ngayon. Kung meron po kayong pangangailangan na tingin nyo ay makakatulong kami, please do not hesitate to contact us. Thank you po. Thank you, Sir Jason, kay Doc Jill, and the rest of the training team. Maraming salamat po sa inyo.
Thank you very much, Doc Rico. And as mentioned by our trainer, Doc Rico, abangan nyo po yung massive training namin on bamboo frame face shield production. So, ang sekreto lang po, sumulat lang kayo sa aming director, kay Dr. Romulo T. Agangan, para sa mga needs nyo po, hindi lang po sa bamboo frame face shield, sa engineered bamboo production. Kung may mga training pa ho kayo na gustong i-avail at saklaw po ng aming mandate, as Forest Products Research and Development Institute. We will be very happy to entertain them and to provide you with those training if kaya po ng ating oras. Pero gusto ko pong ipalam sa ating mga participants na mula ngayong linggong to hanggang sa last week ng October, DOST-FPRDI will offer you series of training webinars. So weekly po, meron kayong matatanggap na training mula sa DOST-FPRDI. At gaya po ng sabi ko kanina, gusto ko pong pasalamatan yung mga kasamahan ko sa Training and Manpower Development Services section. Ngayon po, ang nakikita nyo lang ay kami ni Doc Rico, pero po silang mga kasama natin na nasa likod ng camera ngayon, sila po yung matyagang nagtitingin ng ating mga ginagawang live webinar at sila rin po yung gumagawa ng mga necessary preparations for our training webinar. So muli po, maraming salamat kay Dr. Jill Siladan, our Section Chief sa Training and Manpower Development Services Section. At sa lahat po ng kasama namin sa section, hindi ko na po kayo isa-isahin. Maraming salamat po sa inyong tulong sa training webinar na ito. At sa atin po mga participants, maraming salamat po sa pagbibigay ninyo ng oras. At sana po yung mga konti naming request na training evaluation, sana po ay yun ang ibigay nyo naman sa amin sa training webinar na ito. Lahat po ng training webinars na ibibigay namin mula ngayong araw na to hanggang sa last week ng October, lahat po yun ay libre. So abangan nyo po sa aming official Facebook page ng DOST-FPRDI ang series of trainings na ibabahagi po namin. Ngayong linggo po to hanggang sa Webes, mula ngayon hanggang Webes po, araw-araw po meron tayong training webinars. At yun po, usually, ibinibigay po natin mula 10 o'clock ng umaga. So, to formalize all your queries regarding trainings and other concern, ito po ang aming email, info@fprdi.dost.gov.ph. At tapos po kay, naka-address po dapat yung kay Dr. Romolotti Aganga ng aming director dito sa ahensya. So we ipo-post din po namin sa chat box yung aming email, official email address. So with that po, maraming sa inyo, maraming salamat sa inyong lahat, and that ends our training webinar on Engineered Bamboo Production Level 1. Maraming salamat po. Stay safe, healthy and happy. God bless us all.